Hey everyone, my name is Kaushik. In this video, we are going to learn how to access the clipboard values from our system into a Selenium script. For example, when I click on this button here, it says that the value has been copied, right? So here we are getting a small tooltip which says that it's copied, right? Now if I go to my notepad and if I paste, so here I'm able to get this value, right? Which is this value, right? So whatever the values within this text box, we can copy that and we can paste. So that is how normally clipboards works, right? So what we are going to do now is we are going to copy this and maybe we will open this in another tab, or I can just sys out. So you get the basic ideas, right? Now let's do that in two ways. One is by Java and another one is using the JavaScript. Now let us understand how this really works under the hood. How does the DOM manipulates and also how we are getting this value, okay? So for that, let me give you an example in this. So here we have this value, right? This value is nothing but this exact value. So within the text box, we have a value field where we are getting this. Now, if you noticed here, this is my actual button, right? So this button is here. Now in this, we can see that data clipboard target, it's an attribute, right? So in this attribute, we have this hash foo. That means hash means ID, right? In CSS, hashtag means ID, right? So here if you see ID equal to foo. So whenever this guy is going to click, we are going to do some click action, it is going to take the value from here. That is, it will go and check for the foo ID and it will take the correspondent value. Okay, so that is how in JavaScript it works. So what can we do is we can find this button first. Okay, so we can find this button first, then we can check which ID is located within this data clipboard target. And based on that, we can find in runtime what value it has. So if I get this value, then obviously I can open this in new tab, right? So here I'm going to create a main method. And let me load this website here. So here I'm going to say Chrome driver equal to new Chrome driver. So basic stuff, right? And here I'm going to say driver.get to fetch the URL. And then I'm going to find this button. I have to click on this button, right? So let me inspect this. So here it's image tag. Above that we have button tag, right? So we have to click on this button. But this button doesn't have any, maybe class will be also duplicates, I believe. Yeah, so we have 34, so that won't be a good idea. So what can we do is we can write XPath or maybe the CSS. So let's see how to write the CSS for this. So here it seems like we have ID here, example target. So I'm going to copy this, and here after that I want the below button, right? So button. So we got this now, right? So it's highlighting, so obviously our CSS is correct. So I'm going to copy this, and here I'm going to say driver dot find element by CSS, and here I'm going to paste this, right? Now let's store this in a web element. So I will say button, fine. Now what we want, so from this button we want to get the attribute, right? So this data clipboard target, we want this attribute, right? So I'm going to copy this attribute, and here I'm going to say button dot get attribute of this. Okay, now this is going to return as a string, so I can print this. So let's print and check what it's giving us. So attribute, and let me run this. So the idea is very simple. We are going to get the button attribute, and based on that attribute we are going to find the equivalent ID on the runtime. Okay, so the element has the value which is going to be our clipboard value, right? So let me close this, and here we can see we got this foo, right? Now what we are going to do is we are going to find this element. Okay, so here I'm driver dot find element by CSS, and here I'm going to pass my attribute, right? Because if you see, the attribute holds this value, right? Hashtag and foo, right? So if I go and inspect in this, so here I can see that, so it's belong to that button, right? Now in this button, this actually here we are getting match, but this is actually this value, right? So here I can check that. Okay, so it's giving us this ID foo where it has this value. This is what we have to get right. Okay, so I'm going to store this in a web element, and I can say this as maybe copy or target. And from this target, we want to get the value, right? So target dot get attribute. And within the attribute, I have to pass the value, right? So here I can pass the value, which is nothing but this value, right? So this value is holding this URL, right? So I'm going to take this value now, okay? So here I can store this in another string. So let me name this as value, and let me print this out. So sysout value, okay? So first we will print this value to make sure we are getting the same exact what we needed. Then we will open this in another tab. Okay, so it's ran successfully, and here we can see we got this value, right? So this is what equivalent of this. So when we click on this button, so if I click on this button, it says that copied. Now if I go and paste this here, so obviously it will, I can open this in another tab, right? Now let's understand how to open this in another tab using JavaScript, because we know that Selenium 4 has this feature, but still Selenium 3 doesn't have this feature. So I'm going to trigger the JavaScript code here. So let me open my inspect console, and within the console I'm just going to type so window.open. So window.open is the method which needs a string as an argument, and if I give the string here, it is going to open in a new tab, right? So we got the value. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the value and I'm going to pass this using execute script so that I can open a new tab here. So here I'm going to say driver dot execute script, and within the execute script I have to pass the value, right? So here I'm going to say window dot open, and within the open I have to pass my value, right? Now I cannot pass directly, so I have to do the string concatenation here. So here I'm going to say value, but if you have noticed, within the double quotes we have to give again a double quotes, right? So I'm going to use the break symbol here, so double quotes, and here I'm going to use the break, right? Okay, so this is what the syntax. So here we are getting this value, and here we are using this break so that we can have the double quotes as well. Now let's try to run this. Okay, so now it's opened the new tab which is we are getting from the copy. But now you might ask me, Kaushik, we are clicking on the copy and we are getting the value, but what you are doing is actually you are taking the value from the runtime and you are passing it. But what if when I click on the button and if there is any issue on that, or if there is any bug on that, how do I know that, right? That's a valid question. So doing this way is like, technically if you know JavaScript, this is how under the hood it works, right? But as a tester, we have to do in another ways, right? So the second way might be using robot class, where we can use the control, using the chords, we can use the control V and all those, right? But that's not a good idea, because you know, right? So whenever if someone is going to open any notepad file or any text file, so based on that current location, it is going to type, so which might fail our test case. So the another approach is using the toolkit, right? So let me show you that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just create a main method here, another main method, and I'm going to make this as main one. Now I'm going to run this method, okay? So I'm going to use the toolkit here. So toolkit, which is coming from your java.awt. And here I'm going to get the get default toolkit, right? Now from here, we can get the system clipboard, right? So get system clipboard. And this clipboard is going to return as a clipboard, as a class, okay? So let me store that. And this is going to clipboard, okay? So we are getting this clipboard. Now from the clipboard, we have to access the data flavor. That is another method. So we have to access the string value from our clipboard, right? So here I'm going to say clipboard. And here I can say get data. And within the data, I have to pass another data flavor, okay? So here it's going to be data flavor, and here we need the string, right? So string data flavor is a static final variable through which I can get this, right? Now if I store this, this is going to return me as an object, but here we can see that this is going to throw us an exception, I mean compile time error, which says that it need to be handled, right? So as of now I'm going to use try catch. You can use the throws as well, so I'm going to use the try catch here, and here I'm going to print this, right? So sysout data. So that's it. Now let me open my notepad and I'm going to write something. So here I'm going to copy this, okay? So right click and copy, and if I run this program you will see what I have copied, right? So we got the answer, right? So let me show you again. So I'm going to just change this, and I'm going to select, and I'm going to copy, and I'm going to run this program again, okay? So we got this value, right? So now let's try to do this using our test case. So I'm just going to copy everything, not maybe everything, we just want this, right? So we want to click on this, so let me bring this here, and here I'm going to say button.click. So button.click, obviously I need to access the driver, so let me copy this again, paste it here instead of creating class variable and all. I think this is pretty much cool. Okay, so we created the object and we also opened this URL, and also we are clicking on the button. That means obviously the clipboard has some value, right? Now based on this I'm going to take this clipboard. So using this clipboard.getData I'm getting the string value, right? Now I have to get this once I copied, right? So I'm going to bring this down. That's absolutely fine. Let me decrease the font size so that you can see. Okay, now what we have to do is we are going to open this in new tab, right? So I'm going to copy this, and here I'm going to paste this here, and instead of value I have to pass this as data, right? So that's it. So let me run this now. Okay, so we are now able to see, right? So we got the value from the clipboard, and we are able to open that in a new tab. Either you can open in a new tab, or you can paste to some text editor or input box, anything, right? So you can do that whatever you want. So in this way we can access the clipboard values, right? So this is a very quick demo. I got this question in Facebook, I saw that and I thought to answer it, but before that someone answered from a blog which has not this implementation but kind of this implementation, where they have used the robot class. But we know that robot class is not that much handy when assume that we are going to run our test case in a headless mode, then obviously robot class is not going to help us, right? So using this get system clipboard and this data flavor, so obviously it is going to help us. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have any queries, you can reach to me, you can comment in the video, and please do like and share. And if you like the video and you want to see more like this, you can subscribe to my channel. So thank you guys, thanks for watching, see you in the next one very soon.